This is episode number 3 of Carbon and its compounds of your class 10 science. This episode is all about to learn what is a hydrocarbon, what are the various classifications and the structures of different types of hydrocarbons. Welcome back to Science Capsule, a perfect self-learning tool for school children. So in the previous episodes, we have seen bonding in carbon atom, versatile nature of carbon compounds. So two episodes, very, very important episodes. If you have not watched those episodes, then I'll give the link in the I button and I'll also provide the description. From there, you can watch all those episodes. Today's episode is all about to know hydrocarbon and related terms. So let us start today's video. Let us start our learning process with the hydrocarbon, the definition of a hydrocarbon. Dear students, here hydrocarbon is a compound which is made up of hydrogen and carbon. The name itself tells that the compound is made of hydrogen and carbon. Those compounds which are made of only hydrogen and carbon, we call it as hydrocarbon. Let's take few examples here. A simplest hydrocarbon, you will find one carbon with four hydrogen atom. This we have already discussed. We call this as a methane. In this compound, you can see that the entire hydrocarbon is made of carbon and hydrogen. So here you will find a hydrogen and a carbon, right? So whenever a compound is made up of carbon and hydrogen, such molecule is known as a hydrocarbon. In the nature, we find the various hydrocarbon, and the name of the hydrocarbon is based on number of carbon atoms. So here, if one carbon atom, it is methane. If it is two carbon atom, it is called ethane, which we will discuss in the next section. But for now, you just understand that here hydrocarbon is a compound which is made of carbon and hydrogen only. So here in this molecule, you can find that two carbon atoms and six hydrogen atoms. So the entirely you can see example one and example two, that the compound is made entirely of carbon and hydrogen. Such molecules are called hydrocarbon. Got it? Students, hydrocarbon is broadly classified into two categories. One is called saturated hydrocarbon and the second type is unsaturated hydrocarbon. Let's understand saturated hydrocarbon by taking some examples. First, I am taking here methane. The structure of methane we have already discussed. So this is the structure of methane, and here with the two carbon atoms, we know that it is ethane. So here the structure of ethane, the member of hydrocarbon we will discuss in the next section. For now, you just understand that it is the structure of methane and this is the structure of ethane. Got it? Now look at the structures very carefully. If you see the structure of ethane, where you will find two carbon atoms and these carbon atoms are bonded by single bond, isn't it? So here you will find a single bond. The compounds, the hydrocarbons which are made of carbon-carbon single bond is what we call saturated hydrocarbon. Got it? We can understand this with another example. When we take an example of three carbon atoms, here you will find that here all these other carbon is bonded to eight hydrogen atoms, and if you see carefully the carbon-carbon bond, here it is single bond, here it is single bond. So between two carbon atoms, you will find only single bond. Throughout the structure, you will find only single bond between carbon and carbon. So when there exists carbon-carbon single bond throughout the hydrocarbon, such type of hydrocarbons are classified under saturated hydrocarbon. Once again, dear students, when there exists carbon-carbon single bond throughout the hydrocarbon, the compound is said to be saturated hydrocarbon. Got it? Dear students, the first member in the saturated hydrocarbon is methane with one carbon atom. Let us discuss various other members of saturated hydrocarbon. This is very, very important. Here, the general name of saturated hydrocarbon is alkane. All the members under this family is called as alkane members with the general formula CnH2n plus 2. And name of the alkane families, right from the lower member of alkane, that is saturated hydrocarbon, to various other members need to be understood. So let us see that also. The lower member of the saturated hydrocarbon is called methane with the molecular formula CH4. If the number of carbon atom is 2, then it is called ethane. If the number of carbon atom is 2, then it is called ethane. Number of carbon atom is 3, then it is propane. Number of carbon atom is 4, then it is called butane. For carbon atom number 5, it is called pentane. And for 6, it is hexane. For 7, it is heptane. 8 carbon atoms would be octane. 9 carbon atoms, then it is nonane. And 10 carbon atoms, it is called decane. You have to remember number of carbon atoms. Accordingly, the naming can be done. So based on number of carbon atoms, the name of the compounds also change. If you know the number of carbon atoms, then the molecular formula of that particular saturated hydrocarbon can be found out by using the general formula as CnH2n+2. Let us take a simple example to find. Suppose here number of carbon atom is 9, then how to find the molecular formula by using the general formula? About that we will see. Here number of carbon atom is 9, so n is equal to 9. So when n is equal to 9, wherever n is there, there you have to put 9. So here C n in place of n, it's 9. And here H2n+2, here 2n+2 in place of n, we have to add 9. So here 2 × 9+2, so 2 9s are 18, plus 2 is 20. So C9 and H, here we have to write 20. So C9 corresponds to nonane, and your formula you see here C9H20, the same formula we have obtained from the general formula of alkane. So if you remember the general formula, then it's very easy to find the molecular formula of that particular compound. So this is all about saturated hydrocarbon. Whenever we talk about saturated hydrocarbon, the general name of the hydrocarbon needs to be understood, the general formula of the alkane family, and the various members of the alkane family, which are the saturated hydrocarbon. So far we have understood what is a saturated hydrocarbon. Let us understand unsaturated hydrocarbon by taking some of the examples. So we have two structures, this is structure 1 and this is structure 2, and both these structures are hydrocarbon since they are made up of carbon and hydrogen. If you look at carefully these structures, between two carbon atoms you will find a double bond. Here in the structure 1 you will find a double bond between two carbon atoms, whereas in case of the structure 2 you will find a triple bond. So triple sharing, triple covalent bond you will see. So about the double and the triple bond we have already discussed in the previous episodes. So you can now watch those episodes for more understanding. Here look at the structures very carefully. In the structure 1 you will find carbon-carbon double bond. So here we can write it as carbon-carbon double bond. In structure 2 we can find carbon-carbon triple bond. So here the structure 1 and the structure 2 are called unsaturated hydrocarbon. Then what is an unsaturated hydrocarbon? Dear students, unsaturated hydrocarbons are those hydrocarbons in which two carbon atoms are bonded by either double bond or triple bond, which means in a compound, in a hydrocarbon, you will find at least one double bond or one triple bond between two carbon atoms. Such type of hydrocarbons are called unsaturated hydrocarbon. Got it? So based on whether the hydrocarbon contains double bond or the hydrocarbon contains triple bond, the unsaturated hydrocarbon is broadly classified into two categories. The unsaturated hydrocarbon which contain at least one double bond is classified under alkene family. So the general name of the family members of hydrocarbons which contain double bond is called alkene. And the general formula which we have discussed in case of saturated hydrocarbon, right? Here the general formula of the alkene family would be CnH2n. The hydrocarbon which contain triple bond is classified under the general name alkyne. And it has the general formula CnH2n-2. Got it? So on the basis of the general formula and the general name, the hydrocarbons can be named accordingly. In the saturated hydrocarbon, we have seen the general name as alkane, and with the general formula CnH2n+2, and the members, the first member of the hydrocarbon, saturated hydrocarbon, was methane. Whereas in case of unsaturated hydrocarbon, whether it is alkene or alkyne, the first member under alkene or alkyne family would be with two carbon atoms. Let us see all those things. Based on number of carbon atoms, the name of the unsaturated hydrocarbons can be written. So the first member under alkene and alkyne family would be with two carbon atoms. If two carbon atom, it is called ethene, and the general formula would be C2H4. How do we get the molecular formula of alkene family? It's very simple, by using the general formula. With the help of general formula of alkene and alkyne family, we can find the molecular formula of the members of those family. So here n, value of n should be known. Value of n is number of carbon atom. If number of carbon atom is 2, then Cn, so n is 2, and H 2n, here 2n means 2 into 2, that is 4. So here C2H4, so we have already found out, right? So you can do yourself for other carbon atoms or other family members. For 3, the name is propene, and the formula would be C3, and 2n means 2 into 3, 6, so H6. Likewise, if number of carbon atom is 2, for alkyne family also we can find, the name of the compound would be ethyne, and the general formula is C2H2. So by applying the same general formula, you will get the molecular formula of other members of the alkyne family. So if number of carbon atoms are 3, then its formula would be C3H4, and the name of the compound would be propyne. Likewise, you can find other members in the saturated hydrocarbon. We have seen, if the number of carbon atom is 2, then it's ethane. So here in all the hydrocarbon series, what you have to keep in mind is that the last 3 letters of the hydrocarbon, if it is alkene family members, then the ending 3 letters would be ene. You see here also we have nene. If the hydrocarbon belongs to alkyne family, then the last 3 letters would be ine. If it is the alkane family, then the last 3 digit would be ane. So ane means alkane, which is a saturated hydrocarbon. Ene, if the hydrocarbon ends with ene, then it will have double bond and it is the member of unsaturated hydrocarbon, that is alkene family. And if the hydrocarbon ends with yne, it is the family members of alkyne, which is an unsaturated hydrocarbon. Other than the last 3 letters of the hydrocarbons, irrespective of whether they are saturated or unsaturated, the name of the compound will be the number of carbon atoms. Students, for your practice, I'm giving some work here. You have to find, for number of carbon atoms 4, what would be the name of the alkene, and that's a general formula. For alkyne also you have to find. Likewise, for 5 carbon atoms, 6 carbon atoms and 7 carbon atoms, what would be the name of the unsaturated hydrocarbon in case of alkene and alkyne, that you have to find out. Still, if you find it difficult, then you can mention it in the comment section. I'll give the answer for all these questions. So this is all about saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbon.